I feel like this is gonna be one of those memes where it's like, I'm just a concealer girl. The concealer, it's like all over as my face. But that's what we're gonna do today. And if it helps even things out, so dang be it. That's what we're trying to do. Greetings and salutations. Today we have the brand new Milk Makeup Future Fluid High Tech High Coverage Concealer. Exciting. Retails for $29, comes in 30 different shades, which I will put beautiful collection of models and shades on the screen right now for you guys to reference. I have three shades today. I have 11C, which is a light medium with cool undertones, 12O, which is a medium with olive undertones, and last but not least, 14N, which is a medium with neutral undertones. Milk Makeup was nice enough to send me over a little care package of the three shades, and it also came with their Prism Makeup Sponge, which we will try out today. I have mine damp already, all set and ready to go. I only have brows on right now, no concealer at all, just brow pencil and brow gel. So the ends of my microblading is a little bit out on each side, which we're gonna conceal together. And I also want to disclaim that there's a huge blistery pimple thing in the middle of my lips. I got this Saturday night. Today's Monday when I'm filming. It was my nephew's first birthday. There's a Filipino feast at his birthday party, as it always is, because he's half Filipino. And I don't know, in the middle of the night, this was happening. And I was like, oh my God. So the fluid's been draining, it's healing. I would have distracted you guys with a little bit of lip color, but to be honest, I just cannot be bothered, and it's gonna show through regardless, so ignore it. Now you're looking at it, I know. We got other things we gotta work on right now. Of things. So these shades were picked out from Milk Makeup themselves. This is an all over cream concealer, which I've seen on their socials being worn as, of course, just under eye concealer, highlight, contour, and or base, which I do like to test it out in all kind of avenues. But with the shades that we have, I think we might be able to get a fresh face, under eye, and maybe some of these acne scars concealed up. So let's take a look. No primer, no nothing. Kind of that before. So we have two options right now. We have the very well loved and known Milk Hydro Grip Face Primer. This is actually my newer one. I wanted to show you guys the older one I have, which is definitely about to be tossed because it's expiring. But you can see the color difference just as reference later on. If you have both, I think this is the fresher looking color when it starts to look a little light green. Got a little bit of issue on your hands, but I think this one is the original that came when it first released. So I haven't used that in a bit, and they sent like a refill as of earlier this year. I also have the Hydro Grip Eye Primer. We tested this a few times. I didn't see a huge difference on my eye makeup. Maybe my lids are too oily or something like that, but one of their professional makeup artists did use this with this concealer on her face, and supposedly that really helps with textured areas. And since we have texture in our nose and around our chin, I thought that would be a great way to see if that works. I already know the Hydro Grip itself helps things last longer, but I want to see the smoothing aspect of it, especially in those areas. In the packaging, we have a large doe foot applicator. It's kind of teardrop shaped. It says to dab for precision and to swipe using the sides for more coverage. Again, medium to full coverage concealer, so it's supposed to be buildable and weightless and second skin like. So let's find out. Let's see what these shades look like though. So I'm going to do a swipe instead so we can really see the color. This is 11. C. This is 12O, which is, I'm gonna bet, closest for our skin. Medium with olive. And this is 14N, which is probably my skin at the like summer peak. More neutrally, less golden, but you can really see the tone difference. And there's always a fine line between liquid and cream, and this is definitely giving cream, where it's holding, you know, its pigment throughout. It doesn't feel super liquidy, it feels a little bit heavier, though it should say weightless. You never know when it blends out. Usually during swatches, the pigment is packed all together. So giving it a second to kind of see if anything changes on us. So now that we've given it a moment, I don't think 11C is gonna work at all for us. We might be working with the other two shades. Not bright enough, particularly to give us a like bright under eye. I think we need something a little lighter. Let's look at the models together. Since they are in the mediums, that makes a lot of sense. I think we need to go, maybe 10W or 9N together if we wanna do that, because we have basically the shades towards the end of this row. And interesting enough, I actually see the model for 9N all the time. Now she's a very common model in the same shade range, shade tone that I'm in. So that's also interesting, kind of like as a reference. Milk Makeup, if you ever need a medium golden gal. This actually goes to all brands. You know where to find me. All right, so I think we should put a little bit of the eye primer kind of around that nose area and see if it helps. I'm gonna do it just like from the dot over, give that moment. So I have redness there that I'm definitely gonna wanna conceal. So I'm gonna swipe it in, let it sit for a second, and do the same thing to the side of our chin. And I'm gonna use a little bit of the face primer on the prime side. We're just gonna keep all the primer onto this side of the face and see how that helps. And kind of put that over this little contoury area into these sunspots, because I do tend to lose coverage there first. I have kind of equal acne scars on this side, but this side is very focused on that cheekbone area. So put a little bit of that in. Both products need 30 seconds to set. So let's talk about the sponge. The sponge is cute and marbly. It has a really good consistency. It gives me the e.l.f. Camo Sponge Revamp. The original one was really nice and soft. This is the original, but they redid it. And it's closer to this consistency now, a little stiffer. I feel like there's a little bit of water in it, so I'm gonna squeeze all that out. It's flat on the bottom, pointy at the top, prism shaped. And let's do it. So let's start on the not primed Soyed. This is 12O. Do a little here, here, and here. Maybe a little swipes. See, it's really easy to dot on with the tip. Wow, but it's staying in place. Do you see that? Wow, okay. And then into the redness textured area of my nose. Wow. Using a sponge is giving us a little bit more medium coverage off just the first layer because it's definitely gonna absorb. But if you use the brush, I can see how it'd be full coverage immediately. Whew, that looks really good. I feel like this is gonna be one of those memes where it's like, I'm just a concealer girl. The concealer, it's like all over as my base. But that's what we're doing today. That's like truly what we're doing. We're doing concealer where it's needed. And if it helps even things out, so dang be it. That's what we're trying to do. That looks really good. It matches the center of my face very nicely. I do think 14N will be closer to my arms. My arms are fading. The summer tan is almost gone. I would say it's probably at a 30%. Right now, I do have a trip to the West Coast in a week. So it might come back for a little bit, but not too much, not at full force. I think maybe we'll get back to like 80% tan, but this looks fabulous. Redness concealed already. You can see on this side what it usually looks like. And even to my chin redness, you can kind of see where it's ended right there. Needs a little more right here. I kind of like the shape of the sponge. It's not too small, but it's not huge either. So it's kind of precise. It's giving like just the right like length for my chin. I didn't really put much on the forehead at all. I don't mind. I had just a little discoloration around the eyebrow. For someone who's just running errands today, this base ain't bad. This base ain't bad at all. I think we can try a little bit of 11C just kind of as a corrector under the eye. And then I'll go in with just a little bit of something else that's brightening maybe. But I don't mind a little peachiness there to counteract discoloration. It's so visible how well it just stays put in place versus immediately dispersing. I'm actually quite excited to see if it kind of covers that microblading. Let's try it with a brush. I do like it better with a sponge. I do feel like there's just a little bit of an impression from the brush. Nothing too crazy. Just takes a little extra work. Sponge is absolutely faster. This is our not prime side. Still looks extremely smooth. Feels actually very good. Weightless, yes, right now. Second skin light, absolutely. Looks like my skin had no flaws and has some good moisturizer on right now. Doesn't look heavy, which is what we like in this house. So let's do the same thing to the prime side. And I know the small packaging can be a little confusing because usually we're used to seeing concealers like this. A little bit leaner, a little bit taller. But this has 7 milliliters, the one size concealer, one of my favorite concealers, and this has 8.5, though it's just a little bit shorter. Actually great for kits and packing for sure, or even just throwing in your purse and carrying around. I could see this being something that you could blend out with your finger or keep a tiny little sponge with you. I like that this is something that blends out pretty well, that doesn't give a super harsh line. So as long as you really got the correct shade and you placed it where you wanted to, you could totally wear this alone. So this would be perfect for my non-foundation girlies. This also looks like a really good concealer as far as something you don't have to wait to thicken up. Like, it's gonna stay in place and it's gonna hold its pigment, so you don't have to apply and then give it a few minutes. Some formulas do that and that's totally fine, but some people prefer not to wait. Some people have to go, go, go. I know a few friends who are like, I have 10 minutes to get ready in the morning and they gotta go to work, so time is money sometimes. But I also like that it feels you're getting a lot out of the amount you're using because it's not spreading so much. I don't see this as a product that you would need to layer all over. I think it would give what it needs to give almost immediately. My strong eyebrow, the muscle that always is flexing, the muscle that's always given me too much arch on one side, it's getting a little bit more love than the other side because it just grows differently, it just acts differently. But this looks really good. I have a little bit of brow gel there. I think that's it for the base. It looks really good. I don't think 14N is dark enough to give us any sort of shade. We can apply it right here on this acne scar. Yeah, it's not giving us any contour for sure, but we can pat that in with a brush because I have little dots, not my main one, but little tiny moles that are popping up, little sunspots. I really do like it with a sponge better. It gives the finish the most smooth, buttery look. Currently, the fine lines under my eyes, especially my big guy, the Great Divide, I have one on each eye, is not breaking up. It is not separating right now. My eyelids have not destroyed it. My eyelids are very oily. I don't have a large layer on top. It's very sheer, but I can see just a small amount of oil, and that makes sense for the amount that's on there. Texture is pretty happy. I do think the prime texture side looks a little better than the not prime side. You can see kind of more something going on there. Exciting. So not much to report in. The pores are non-existent. This is giving what it said, second skin. I hear that all the time, but this is it. This is second skin. We like it. We really like it. So do we set this? I don't know. I feel like we have to set our oily areas. Maybe we set one eye and see how the other one does. Commit to looking crazy, maybe. I have Makeup Forever HD 2.0 Banana. Little bit. I'm gonna use a pointed puff. These are from Amazon. Taking just a very small amount. I don't know if I should, I'm hesitating on if I should do the prime side or the not prime side, but I think not prime is gonna win. This powder is known to be really smoothing too. I've tested it separately. It has its own video. It's one of the good ones, you know? So we've taken it just along the top of the brow, like with the tip of the sponge, because we had a little concealer set there, so we're setting that. And then we've gotten this small triangle done down to the nose. So that looks really smooth and really good. I'm gonna do the same thing right here and onto the tip of the nose, just because I'm so oily there and I wanna see if that's gonna make a difference. It's gonna kill what we got right away, but maybe in the long run, it's gonna look a little better. I mean, this finish looks a lot better to me, so. So I have just a little bit of Fix Plus left. I wanna hit this side with a little bit of refreshing spray because I don't want to look so dramatically different on both sides. And I feel like we're kind of there. I think we need to put the powder across our eyelid too because it's about to break up on us a little bit. Kind of set it so I can put some eye stuff on it later. So let's hope. Okay, the Fix Plus isn't spitting too hard right now, but just a little bit on that side, almost like blocking the whole side of my face. Fix Plus is more refreshing than setting, so it shouldn't change the long wear situation. It's gonna just make that finish look a little bit more hydrated. And we'll see if primer is the way to go or powder is the way to go. I'm gently gonna tap in the Fix Plus with the base of the sponge to help it absorb just a little faster. All right. You can actually see that the coverage looks really intense now right here, even though it's a sheer powder. Like, under eye wise. It's not too crazy, it's not too different. I think this is good enough to give you guys some starting point pictures. I am gonna be finishing my eye makeup in a separate video, so make sure you stay tuned and check that out. But I'm gonna give you guys some close-up cam footage on the concealer, starting point pictures in a second, and I'll see you guys at the end of thy day. Nine hours later, we are back, and I have so many thoughts, and I'm trying to organize them to make it digestible, and I think we got so much going on today, guys, that it might not be easy, but I'm gonna try my best. As you can see, I have lips, liner lashes, and a little bit of powdered bronzer since last time we spoke, just a little bit to warm the face, because I felt like the face was looking quite round, and I wanted to do a little bit more filming. I did some lip swatches and such today, so that would be an update of what's going on. Now let's look at our pictures, because we did our starting point pictures, but you need to see the end of the day ones. Overall, I think this formulation photographs beautifully in flash photography, so there's no photo concerns, flash, no flash. Immediately, when I sat down, my eyes went to a certain area. Are you looking at the same area I'm looking at right now? It would be this under eye. Our prime side. Recapping, this is prime, this is powder. Powder is kicking prime's butt hard in the under eye area. Like, this is a 9 out of 10, easily. Even a 9.5 out of 10. The only thing I can see in this area is my Great Divide, which is my biggest crease, minor. minor appearance right there. Otherwise, smooth as butter. An amazing pairing with this powder. Highly recommend it for my oily gals to use with this concealer and with a lot of your concealers. It just does the job. While this side has a little bit of fallout sticking to it. It's from my lashes. I've reused my lashes plenty of times. Same thing would happen with mascara or pencil liner, anything that like as you blink would slowly transfer onto any sort of adherent area. We get this. Does not happen within the first few hours. This happened probably 4 or 5 hours in, which kind of means that this cream concealer never fully sets. It's not a cream, the powder. Some formulas do that. This is not one that claims to. So you will get this if you don't set it. But maybe you want to hold that hydrated finish. You don't want this cream powder look. You want just that closer to second skin like finish. Then I would advise to take a transparent blotting powder of some sort and just kind of upkeep it. That's the best way you'd be able to do that, in my opinion, if you have products on that would transfer. Mascara, lash glue, pencil liner. If you don't have any of those products on, I think you'd actually be pretty good to go, but you are gonna see more fine lines and texture. As you can see, I see quite a bit of fine lines and accentuations there, and overall this eye looks tired compared to this side. Primer wise, the face primer kicked butt. It's under this bronzer, so it only has concealer and bronzer on top. I try to keep how many layers I put on top of this Hydro Grip primer to a minimal because it starts to get crazy because this is a tacky primer. It works well as far as holding on and gripping, and that's why this cheek looks way more vibrant than this cheek, though this side looks pretty good still. This side has that intensity and that perfect smooth coverage, all thanks to this primer. But the areas that we use the Hydro Grip eye primer, these pores close to the under eye, the sides of the nose, and the sides of the mouth, don't look any better than the side without. If anything, certain areas look worse. I feel like I have more fading around this area on the prime side than the not prime side. I think the nose looks a little bit more accentuated, like more of the pores are standing out on the nose. The crevice looks a little cakier, and I don't think it looks any smoother under the eye. So overall, this doesn't work for my lids, and this doesn't work for my face. And I'm so sad because I had such high hopes for the potential of these two working well together after they posted it. But unfortunately, it feels like I've just been hanging on to this for no apparent reason because it's not one of those products that are gonna work for me. Maybe it works for other people out there, but my oily lids said no, and my textured face said no thank you. So I'm gonna stick to being a Grip fan. I bought the setting spray recently, and I can't wait to try that out, so make sure you stay tuned for my first impressions of that, because I know a lot of people love the Milk Hydro Grip setting spray, and it's one of the few things I have not tried within their line. Overall, my face does feel lightweight. I could look cakier, I could feel tight. I feel hydrated, which is all I can really ask for at the end of the day. I don't think I would say this concealer is giving me top three, but it could land top five. It could be fifth place, maybe fifth, sixth place. It's not super special to me, but its shade range is really nice. Its price point is not bad. And overall, it could be worse. Like, it applied pretty well. And I don't mind the combination look, so I could use this again. I probably will. I do think the packaging's gonna get annoying. That bothers me a little bit because when I was trying to do some palette swatches, the stopper holds on for dear life. Like, there's a ginormous stopper and it aims all the products at just the tip of the applicator, so you really are kind of stuck dabbing compared to swiping. And it is a double dip situation, triple dip sometimes, compared to a lot of concealers now where you don't need a double dip at all. Like, there's enough product on it. So it doesn't seem like a problem, but I think as you start finishing up the concealer, it's gonna be like, all right, get some out, and it's gonna be tedious. That's just the vibe it's giving me. I don't typically worry about packaging in the future, but the future fluid got me thinking. It just seems troublesome. But that's for a problem of another day, it seems. I thought I would just note it. It does claim to have crease-proof coverage. My under eyes would like to have a word with those who write those claims. My fine lines look pretty okay. They're not smoothed over. Fine lines can crease too, that's all I'm saying. Is it medium to full coverage? Yes. Absolutely. Does it hold in the place that you want it to? Yes, absolutely. It doesn't slide around. It's not overly creamy. It says it's a whipped creamy formulation. I think it's just like a cream. It's a cream. No fancy adjectives. It's a cream. It sticks. It dries fast. And the coverage does hold up, but then it does start to fade without all the smoothing effects. And with all that being said, I think I'm okay with giving this a B. With powder, B+. If you're gonna use it with the powder, B+. Otherwise, I mean, I don't think you need to run out and get it. If you're interested in it and you want to try it, I don't think it's a bad idea either. It's not a must have. But those are just my thoughts from my experience, and I hope all these thoughts somehow became digestible for you guys, because it's been a long, long day. I've been recovering from being sick, and I'm just doing my best out here in these streets. If you're interested in hanging out with me any longer, I have some recent uploads on the screen right now. That will be it for today's video. So if you'd like to subscribe to see future content, the button will be right here. And it's time for me to go get some rest. Final look at the face. As you can see, it is slightly breaking through oily. Even though both sides are doing that, this side looks better and it feels pretty good to the touch, but I wouldn't go without adding a little bit more powder to your super oily areas. And as you can see, there is slight oiliness at the end of my nose. It's manageable. It's not bad. It looks better on this side than this side too. So a little bit of powder could fix that easily. Otherwise, the rest of my face feels great. Those are the final thoughts. I keep talking because I don't want to miss anything, but I gotta let y'all go now. I'll see you in a later video.